Now we are going to do the poem Freedom by Jayanta Mahapatra. So Jayanta Mahapatra is one of the major Indian English poet, and then he is the first Indian poet to win Sahitya Academy Award for English poetry. So this poem Freedom, as its title goes, the leitmotif is freedom itself. The major theme is freedom itself. We are going to see different aspects of freedom. Okay, the poem draws upon the Indian belief system that death as freedom from the body, the bondage from the world, etc. We will see this poem in detail line by line. At times as I watch, it seems as though my country's body flowed down somewhere on the river. So at times it feels that the country's body, like India as together, is like a dead body that is floating on a river. We know that it is in river Ganges in Varanasi that people, the body are cremated and then it is being the ashes are being put. But then here the poet says that it seems that the country's body is floating on the river. Left alone, I grow into a half disembodied bamboo, its lower part sunk into itself on the bank. So when I am left alone, I am just like a bamboo, a half disembodied bamboo whose lower part sunk itself on the bank. Here old widows and dying men cherish their freedom, bowing time after time in obstinate prayers. So here, according to this, the widows, they are free because they are free from the old marital bondage and everything. And even the dying men, they are free. According to this poem, according to this poet, it is said that the widows are free. And that is the common belief that India has also. And then they remain away from all the worldly pleasures, and then they remain in prayers. While children scream with this desire for freedom to transform the world without even laying hands on it. Children, the younger generation, they want to do so much for the society. They want to do so much, but then they are being restrained by the elders. In my blindness, at times I fear I would wander back to either of them. In order for me not to lose face, it is necessary for me to be alone. So the poet feels that it is necessary for him to be alone so that he need not face all this and he need not lose his face. Note to me, the woman and her child in that remote village in hills who never had even a little rice for their daily meal for these 50 years. India claims to be free for 50 years. This poem is written in 1997, where India completes 50 years of freedom. And the poet says that even though India got 50 years of freedom, it is only in written form. And the poor women and child, they are not free from hunger. And not to see the uncaught bloody light of sunset cling to the tall white columns of Parliament House. This here, the line, in this line, he speaks about Indian politics, how politics are very crucial and how common people are drawn into it and how many bloodshed happens. In the new temple man has built nearby, the priest is the only one who knows freedom, while God hides in the dark like an alien. So in the temples are built by men. In the temples where God is supposed to be there, the God doesn't have any freedom. The God is shut behind. It is the priest who decides who will see the God, when they will see the God, and how they will worship. It is the priest who decides. Here, a note can be said about the untouchables, how untouchables are not allowed to enter the worship places and all. And each day I keep looking for the light, shadows find excuses to keep. Each day I am looking for the light in which is being kept away by the shadows. Here light, shadow put together. The juxtaposition happens, opposite things are put together for contrasting effect. And each day I keep looking for the light, shadows find excuses to keep. Here juxtaposition is done to enhance the poetic effect. Trying to find the only freedom I know, the freedom of the body when it is alone. The poet says that he knows only one freedom, the freedom of the body when it is alone. The freedom of the silent shale, the moonless call, the beds of stream, of the sleeping god. I keep the ashes away, try not to wear them on the forehead. So he says that he keeps the ashes away, he tries not to wear them on the forehead. He means that this is a kind of... somewhat way it is a kind of satirizing upon the country, that whatever be the superstitious belief or whatever be the customs that the country is being, say, those ashes, like we know that ashes has religious aspect. So he says that he doesn't wear that ashes on the forehead, and then he keeps the ashes away. He's away from all this, he's away from all these worldly bondages. Even in this, religious beliefs are also a kind of bondage, emotional bondage that is done on a person. So he is free from all this. He wants to be alone, and he finds it is by being alone that he can be a better person. He can do something better. I hope the poem is clear to you. Thank you.